Doc when he was playing Fox, like, 2 semesters ago.
Yeah.
And since he switched to Teachman, he's been on a tear.
Well, it's not just that, because
he's gotten better.
He understands Peach a lot better than he understood Fox, but also, like, I feel like every single week I see him, he gets better.
Yeah. This is round 2, and Peach.
Oh, yes, correct.
They're just doing hand warmers. I'm going to tilt this a little bit just so I can see it.
Yeah, go for it. Peach, default.
I think it's Falco.
Red.
Is it red?
I don't play red.
Okay. I like this layout a lot.
Yeah, it's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm actually going to change this title. Hello. Just a bit. I'll make it.
That MU weekly so it doesn't run into the thing at the top. Yeah, I got you. There we go. That's better.
That's much better. Yeah.
All right.
Oh, that looks like so much more symmetrical now.
This, it's an even matchup, right? Or do you think Peach might actually win?
I think Falco wins neutral, but Peach wins punish.
I agree, yeah.
But, like,
Falco can't do his pillar combos like he can on a lot of other characters on Peach because she's too floaty.
Well, he can, she can. It's harder.
Right.
Yeah, so, right off the bat, I was talking about when Daikami is playing that you gotta be down air is very late on the shield, otherwise you're very susceptible to shield grabbing.
Yes.
And right off the bat, you can just see this very high aerial and like a lot of shine immediate down airs.
Ooh, that was nice.
So you gotta be careful with this kind of stuff.
How do you feel about the stage choice? I actually really like it.
Well, I like this stage a lot as a floaty main. So
I mean, like, for this matchup, I actually think it's a smart pick. I'm guessing Adamo won.
I think it's good for both parties.
Mm-hmm.
Falco can kind of get in on Peach a lot more so that she can't pull turnips or anything, but at the same time, Peach doesn't have to chase Falco down.
Mm-hmm.
The spacing is a lot more closed in.
Right.
So it's going to be a lot easier for her to get her hits. Also on the platforms, because of their variable height, like, a lot of her attacks like Down Smash become a lot more dangerous.
Right.
So it
and also because it's such a...
Yeah, right
has
there.
Smaller horizontal blast zones, Falco could potentially kill Peach a little bit earlier than normal if he gets an F Smash near the ledge. Is he going to punish it? No. Okay. If Pancakes can just get a grab, then he can get a big punish off of it.
Oh, yeah, you gotta watch your drift when you come in like that, Peach.
This is one of Falco's hardest matchups, in my opinion. That was weird.
That was kind of weird.
That was weird.
I think it's still pretty good, it's just that...
It's hard to play. I'm not saying it's not a bad matchup at all, but it's hard to play because your lasers aren't worth quite as much because she can float in between them. So you have to mix up your approach options a bit more. You could have done a double down air. You'd probably get a down smash on the bottom platform. Ooh!
Yeah.
And that was a relatively early kill for Peach. Again, pick out the F smash at, I think, like 90%.
Oh.
You always feel bad when you see the down smash. Just send them
completely
sideways. I miss it. What happened?
Domo SD'd.
Was he trying to ledge stall?
No, he just kind of, like, whipped the back air and fell off the stage, I think.
I get Gork and Betty Crocker on the open setup.
It's funny because if you look at, like, how, like, look at their faces while they're playing, Adamo looks so serious, and Pancakes just looks, like, stoic and nonchalant about the whole thing.
Oh, Adamo takes it. Nice.
Where would you go if you were Pancakes?
If I was Pancakes?
Obviously he's going to ban... I don't know. What would he ban? Would he ban FD or would he ban Dreamland?
I think he'd ban Dreamland.
Dreamland.
Well...
Yeah.
Dreamland's pretty good. The only problem is that Falco can run away.
Falco can run away, but Peach will also live forever.
And this is true. It just kind of depends on your style as a Peach, as a Peach player, and as a Falco player, like what you don't want to play on. So,
like, I know Andrew would actually rather go. I know Olaf would rather go to Dreamland because he was more than happy to run away and his laser. Mm-hmm. And then just take his hits where he can get them. Yeah. That was a nice little combo. But I feel like Adamo looks like a more aggressive Peach.
Oh yeah, Adamo is super aggressive.
It looks like he's using the lasers more to frustrate. Versus Andrew, who will use them, or Olash will use them to just rack up some damage and then get the hits that he needs.
Yeah. Oh, nice power shield.
That was a nice shot out shield. He's still trying to go for pillar combos. But it's really all he can do on the stage if he's hoping to get big damage out of it, instead of just hitting it with a back air or an air.
Oh, that was a really good drift. I like that a lot.
You don't see float tech chasing with Peach that often.
Well, the reason I really like that is because he drifted in towards the stage, so even if Adamo didn't tech in, he would have had center stage.
That was great coverage on the ledge. The down air to cover if he tried to ledge stall. Yeah. He doesn't have this forward. This is still really tricky.
Nice. Oh.
Edge guarding Peach is so tricky. Especially with a spacey, because if you overextend, you are dead.
Oh, that was sick.
Did he power shield?
Yeah, he did.
Back air from ledge.
Alright, I got a mash to go to.
You're good, man. Alright, Javi had to go play his match. Who's he playing? I have no idea who Javi's playing. Pancakes has a slight lead here, but it's still well within the realm of possibility for Adamo to be able to come back from this. Who's he playing? Oh, Javi has to play less than. Alright, this is all even up. Only 10% difference, it's honestly nothing. Oh, but he eats a down smash. If Pancakes can get a grab, that should be it. Get the chain grab. I think the chain grab goes really high. He's going for the nair. He could still be trying to grab. Oh, those were great lasers. I am normally completely against double laser from ledge. But those were actually phenomenal lasers. Alright, so it's 1-1. Great stuff from Pancakes to bring that out. Pancakes played that very well. It's a Battlefield. I'm guessing he banned Yoshi's, so yeah, Battlefield. Maybe he banned Pokemon. If he didn't ban Pokemon, I think he should have gone to Pokemon. Because you have the room to laser and run away. But you also have a low ceiling, so if you can poke with a down tilt, then you can do a lot of damage. You can get a lot of early kills off that. But it looks like he is trying to run away a bit more, use his lasers. That was a nice little down air to forward smash. Adama's looking crisp this time. Great air dodge on stage. Pancake still looks unfazed by most of this. These are two of the better players that are here by far. Oh, is he going to get battlefielded? No, okay. He was able to make it back. Let's get Javi off of this.
Jiggy and back!
What? Good, you? Alright, he's probably high as fuck, but that's fine. Flames on Dank for nothing. But Adamo is looking a little bit more safe this time, and as I say that, he does an early dare on shield, but he gets out of it. He gets a decent little 30% combo. He was holding down to just drift past the ledge. He didn't even mean it. I hate to see that. Ooh, the runoff back air. Goes straight in, and then he gets blundered on the top platform. Didn't get the short limp that he wanted, but it still worked for him anyway. And Pancakes isn't able to pull up the edge guard. Pancakes seems to be chasing him a little bit, which is probably what Adamo wants him to do. Because Adamo could just stay and just keep lasering. But Adamo is a more aggressive player. Like right there, when he dropped to the platform, Pancake put himself in a not a very good situation because he doesn't have a really good option to defend himself from above, except for maybe up there, which still you need a decent reaction. Well, Falco has many good options coming down. Down air, back air, nair, all good options coming down. Plus you can stall and boot something out with Shine. But Pancakes had stage position, but he let Adamo back in. Nair out of shield. The down smash. Oh, what was he doing? That was a stock. If he just nared, forwarded, one of them would have killed. But Adamo is looking much better this time. I'm sure that was supposed to be Shine at shield. Alright. 40%. For Peach, it's really nothing. If it was Falco with 40% instead, excuse me. If it was Falco with 40% instead, then this would be a bit scarier.
Walrus on the open setup.
Well, hello.
What?
I am commentating. You hopping on?
Yeah.
All right. I'm still waiting for Pete.
Welcome to my MU bracket.
We got Adamo and Pancakes on stream right now, and it's 1-1.
Oh, do we? Nice.
Yeah.
Let's go, Pancakes.
We got Mari on commentary now.
It's Mary. Get it right.
It's fucking Mari.
It's Mary. Stop.
Mari.
Stop.
Everyone has called you Mari. Your name
is
Mari.
You know what? You guys are all wrong.
Adamo looking in the driver's seat right now. That was a great air dodge, though.
It's so loud in here, man.
I don't know. It's really loud. Like, you can actually see the mic spiking even when we're not talking.
Well, yeah, because I don't know. It's no bueno to be this loud.
This is a
was that 2-0?
That was
2-1. 2-1? So let's go, Pancakes.
No, Adamo won.
I know. Well, let's go, Pancakes.
Oh, forgetting that one?
Yeah.
Looks like we're going to have the young Olash.
Olash versus
what is your
James?
Tag?
Yo, they've waited a long time for this.
Again?
So actually, James didn't get